I'm now joined by Richard Di Benedetto, president of Aetna International. The healthcare industry is no stranger to digital transformation. Providers are under constant pressure to reduce costs, improve outcomes, and deliver a personalised and convenient service. Effective use of technology and cognitive analytics are natural solutions. Richard, when did Aetna International begin its digital transformation journey, and how has it helped improve your services?
We started several years ago, but we started as the traditional health insurance. How can I pay your claim faster? How can I get you faster a letter of guarantee for your treatment? But then we realized the power of technology and, more important, what customer wants. Customer wants more personalized healthcare, more affordable healthcare, and even more important, convenient healthcare. And the power of technology helped us not only to redesign our internal process, but map the customer journey and use the data to make it more personal, affordable, and convenient for our customer.
Let's take those three aspects in order then. First of all, personalizing a healthcare journey. How are you using data in order to understand what customers need and then providing them with those needs?
In yesterday's world, we were using data coming from you going to hospitals or seeing a doctor. Today, I can capture your data, for example, through a health risk assessment. What is important for you for your healthcare? Your health goals are different than mine, and are different than a young woman that just gave birth to a child. By knowing you personally, I can define health goals for you, and I can embark you into a journey to improve and connect you also with the healthcare systems during that journey.
Let's talk about the affordability aspect now. Digital transformation is a lot about changing your internal processes in order to make these efficiencies possible. So how have you achieved that, and what's the outcome been?
Number one, you refocus the organization around the customer, and you refocus your process around what are the benefit of the customer and what is a digital customer journey should be. Traditional big companies are organized by silo. Product is here, service is here, care management is here. Customer doesn't care about this. Customer cares about their health, the best treatment at the best time to the right place. So you need to really re-engineer your process along the customer journey, process by process. So this is ongoing, and that is going to continue for years, rethinking the organization, the operating model, and how we look at our company.
Give me some examples of the new digital health services that you're offering to make life more convenient for your members. Yeah.
Geography by geography, we have been building virtual health capability for our members. 24/7 GP or specialist consultation. You can have an advice, you can have a diagnosis, you can have a prescription that we deliver back to your home. You could have some analysis taken back home, like blood test. We can connect you if you need to see a specialist or if you need to go to the hospitals. So we integrate here this healthcare journey with the provider world for the benefit of our customers. We have seen three benefits. The first one is that close to 70% of the members that did use virtual health capabilities did not want to see a doctor in the facilities in the following 30 days. That's a big benefit, and that's a big cost saving for the system also. Number two, members saved in average 2 hours time. You can take a consultation from your bedroom or with your child from your kitchen. Number three, the satisfaction rate is extremely high. So that all three positive elements that really excite us to go deeper in launching virtual health.
Healthcare is about more than just clinical care. Yes. You're also using digital to improve general well-being for your members. Yes. Tell me more.
So 50% of people are qualified as healthy, and they only consume 6% of total healthcare costs. So we need to keep you healthy. I need to keep you healthy, Paul. I need to keep Richard healthy. I need to keep my team healthy. So how do I keep you healthy is back to data. You know, what is important for you in your health journey? I have my own health goal. I have small hernia. Keep up with the hernia. No surgery. Keep doing Pilates. Keep doing extending your core. So make it personal and improve on your health. But you have also 2% of the population that consume 40% of the healthcare costs. For some of them are severely chronic, but you can help them to follow their treatment. Do you have refill for your medication? Are you compliant with your medications? Are you compliant with your diet? Can we check it? We move from we finance health to member health. By that journey, I think we can be the integrator between the payer, the employee, the consumer, the network, to integrate the health journey with one measurement is how can I improve health outcome and how can I keep my member healthy.
Richard, thank you very much.
Pleasure to be here.
Thanks for watching. Click through for more videos on innovation in the healthcare industry, and please subscribe for the latest business, finance, and strategic insights from EuropeanCEO.com.